little morning show, we certainly punch above our weight when it comes to showbiz exclusives. Now, that's because we have two of the best entertainment journalists in the business, Angela Bishop and Craig Bennett, for whom celebrities can't help but open up like daylilies. That's to quote Craig Bennett. So come on, let me entertain you. They are, without a doubt, the best in the biz. Showbiz, that is. Over the past 5 years, they have reported on every big celebrity hatches, matches and dispatches. But it's with their celebrity interviews Ange and Craigie have truly shined. They've even been invited into the homes of the rich and famous.
Paula lives in a stylish condo in the trendy Century City area. She shares the apartment with her beloved dogs, five of the most pampered pooches you are ever likely to meet.
Right, Bessimo?
Now, Paula, I'm noticing the toenail paint there.
It's called a podicure.
A podicure?
Yes, Bessimo knows she has the best nail bed, better than her mother's, and she shows off.
And it's in the safe confines of their private domains that some of our much-loved stars have opened up about the most painful moments of their lives.
In 1985, while Fran and her husband Peter Mark Jacobson were having a dinner party at home, they were the victims of a shocking, violent invasion. Tied up, Fran was raped at gunpoint.
The whole rape experience was so surreal because people who talk about having guns in the house and things like that, it would not have helped.
No.
It would have, could have been used against us. So, you know, there's no time unless you're going to walk around with a gun pointed 24 hours a day. There's no time to say. No, we were home, both home, having dinner, celebrating with a friend, and they broke the door down. It was locked. Nothing was done wrong. And you try to live. You try to get through it alive. And the police said, whatever you did right because you're alive.
Angela's 2016 sit-down with Melissa Etheridge made headlines, but they had nothing to do with the Grammy winner's music.
I'm thinking of Brad Pitt, and I'm thinking of all those rumours at the time that he was the father of your oldest children. Do you remember that, way back when? And there were all sorts of rumours flying around as to who that was.
Well, actually, because he was such a good friend of mine, and we did consider it, and yet I looked and I saw how badly he wanted children, and I thought, I don't want to share this with someone who really badly wants children because my children don't need another parent. They have two. Of course, now my teenagers are like, I could have had Brad Pitt as my son said, I could have been amazingly handsome, but no.
It's a thrill for me, face to face with a new, real Australian friend.
And Craig's irrepressible personality has inspired celebrities to let down their guard.
To the formidable Jerry Lewis, and who Dame Patricia reveals was...
a nightmare. An absolute nightmare.
Did you ever have one of those days?
And I'm afraid, I mean, I will be lambasted for this, but I didn't find him funny at all. And he decided he wanted another take, Mr. Lewis, and another. And another, and another, and another. And there were 14 takes. And I think he wanted to break my spirit, really.
Oh my God.
Jaws have dropped, including ours, after celebrity revelations. For once, Ryan Gosling was lost for words when he sat down with Ange to promote his film Blade Runner.
You had a band called Dead Man's Bones for a while. Is that still a going thing?
No, that was sort of a...
one-off?
Kind of a one-off thing. You know, never say never. It was certainly a lot of fun.
It's a great name. I was in a band called Hard and Fast from Behind.
Oh, my.
Which wasn't quite as good. We'd all had...
Can I get the...
we'd all had
check.
A lot of bourbon when right. we came up with that name. How did you come up with Dead Man's Bones?
Oh, no, I can't top that.
You're just flummoxed.
And I'm just, I'm running a blank.
And it was take two when Ange caught up with Ryan for an out-of-this-world chat at NASA.
Ryan, the last time we spoke was for Blade Runner and we got into a weird conversation about the names of bands. And I think I told you the name of my band, which was called Hard and Fast from Behind, you might remember. You had a pretty... yeah, that was pretty much your reaction then too. That was it. That was it.
Then there were interviews that made news globally. Ange's interview with Harrison Ford about the then US presidential candidate Donald Trump went viral. and was picked up by the most trusted cable news channel in the world, CNN.
Donald Trump said in the not-too-distant past how much a fan...
The beloved Donald Trump that's running for
president of the
resident?
United States.
Oh, president? Oh, I thought it was resident. So he's not only going to live there, he's going to run the show?
That's his plan.
No, it's not so much. No, I don't think so. But what did he say?
He said he was a fan of you, that he loved the way you stood up for America in Air Force One.
Get off my plane.
It's a movie.
And he liked... And he liked
Donald,
the way...
It was a movie. It's not like this in real life. But how would you know?